Hello and welcome to the Django ORM Mastery course, Level 1. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to pretty print the SQL output for any Django query. If you find anything in this tutorial where I'm referring back to different tutorials, this tutorial is part of the Django Database ORM Mastery course. You will find the YouTube edition playlist in the video description so you can view from the very beginning. If you would prefer a more comprehensive step-by-step ad-free approach, then you can definitely check out our Udemy course, Django Database ORM Mastery. There is a link again in the video description, which will always give you the best price for this course. The actual course thumbnail may change over time, so just look for the name Database ORM Mastery, created by Very Academy. In the previous tutorials, we learned that if we utilize the query set API methods that return a new query set and utilize the .query attribute, we can return the SQL related to our query that we're trying to execute. And you can see here that it returns the SQL in essentially just one block. Now, that's okay for smaller SQL statements, but once we start scaling, once we start exploring this in a much more deeper, meaningful way, we'll find that this SQL statement will expand quite considerably. So it might be preferable for us to format this output in a way that makes it easier for us to read. So if you do want to follow this step by step, remember there is a setup guide at the start of this section of this block in this course. So you will need to go through that first. If you have been following this tutorial series step by step, then you're already ready to go. Let me just exit this. So if you are following that tutorial guide, you will be left right here. So the first thing we need to do is go into the Django shell here. And we're ready to start. In order for us to format the SQL in the terminal, we're going to be utilizing two tools. The first is pygmints. And then the second tool is going to be SQL Parse. So essentially, this tool here, the PY or pygmints, is going to provide the tools for us to color the commands. And also then it gives us other options, for example, to format the output in many different ways. And you can have a look at the documentation here. We're not going to explore this. I'm just going to show you how to set this up in a particular way so that we can output that SQL in the terminal in a nice format to make it a lot more readable. Right, so SQL parse, this is essentially going to allow us to split our code. It's going to provide us the tool to essentially split our code into rows. So we saw previously from the SQL statement that it has different kind of sections, so a select component, and then, for example, a where component. We haven't seen that yet. So we're able to split our SQL code into a more kind of linear top-down list approach, and that's going to make it easier for us to read the SQL code in the terminal. So first of all, let's just exit the shell. Sorry, I think I was in the shell previously. So just type in exit parentheses to come back into the virtual environment here, and then we're going to need to install those packages. So pip install, I'll just type it here so you can see it. So I'll go ahead and pip install those two packages. I already have them installed, it looks like. And once those packages are installed, let's just go back into the Python Django shell. Okay, so we're going to need to bring in some resources here. Now, we are wanting to highlight our code. So from the pygmints, we're going to import highlight. So this is one of the classes functionality of this tool. We can highlight our code. So we're going to do that, bring that in. So secondly, we are going to need to tell pygmints what it is we want to format. So here we're utilizing the terminal. So we're going to need to bring in the terminal formatter. Hopefully that makes perfect sense. And then last of all, we do have tools here whereby we may want to apply formatting to different type of code or different formats of code. So for example, the lexicon, the language of, for example, a Postgres database, some of the syntax might be slightly different than if you're, for example, utilizing an SQL, MySQL database or an Oracle database. So Pygements does offer different options. So here I'm just going to bring in the Postgres, even though I'm using SQLite, because there isn't really any syntax difference here. We're not going to have any issues. So I'm just going to bring in the Postgres Lexer. So there is, if you have a look at the documentation, if you're using MySQL, there's different Lexers that you can utilize so that it formats and is appropriate to your database engine. Okay, so last of all then, from the SQL parse, we are going to need to bring in format, and that's going to provide us options then to actually format the code. In this case, like I was saying, we want to make a kind of a list format here. So we're going to bring in SQL parse to kind of format our SQL code in a format that makes it easier for us to view. And we'll see that shortly. So what I can do now is I can copy this into our terminal so we can utilize all these tools. And then we are going to need to make a query. So I do need to bring in a table. We've been utilizing the brand table, remember? So from the previous tutorial. So let's bring in the brand table and make that available. Right, so that's our setup. I'll just clear that. Right, so now what we can do then is we can go ahead and, well, let's just make sure we probably already have, if we're using the same database from the previous tutorial, we probably have some data in our database. So let's just go ahead and delete that. So we're working maybe from the same page. Okay. So we just deleted some data from the database. Let's just bring that down. So I've gone ahead and I'll just quickly type this out. Brand. I regret this now. Apologies. Objects.all.delete. Okay, so we're already all on the same page, hopefully. So now then, let's go ahead and just run a create command. So let's just create some data in our database. One entry, okay. And now let's go ahead and, for example, let's just run a filter. So you may have not seen a filter before, but a filter essentially, and we will obviously explore this further in this course, allows me to select specific items in the database. So here I'm using this filter and I'm saying that I want to return all the data from this brand table where the brand ID equals one. So in this case, it's going to return one item, but it's kind of irrelevant. So let's just go ahead and run that. Okay, so now I want to return this data, this SQL, in a formatted manner and utilizing these tools. So here I am using .query to actually grab the query. So again, if you are utilizing this or you want to utilize this on query set API methods that do not return query sets, this won't work. So this is only going to work on those methods that do return query sets. So from here then, we are going to run SQL formatted. So we're going to create a new variable here called SQL formatted. You can call it whatever you like. So we're going to use format from the SQL parse tools. And then we're just going to format this. I'm going to convert this to a string. So we're going to take X, which is the query set here. And then we're going to adapt or add the query attribute on the end. So that's essentially going to run this query, and then we're going to then go ahead and re-indent. So this is a function parameter of format, which is going to allow us to format our code in this list format. Now, if you look at the documentation, it doesn't actually provide us much information, but if we weren't to utilize this, we would see the SQL code in its normal format in a block line. So this is essentially going to allow us to format the code in smaller blocks based upon the different attributes of our SQL statement. So we'll see that in a second. So we need to set that to true. So do that, and then the end of parentheses there. So we'll run that. And now what we need to do is print all this out. So this is where we now utilize the tools from the PyGements. So we're going to use the highlighter, terminal formatter, and Postgres Lexer. So print, and then we're going to use highlight. So we're going to highlight everything. Now, there are different parameters for this highlighting. It's well worth looking at the documentation for that. But essentially, what we need to do here is we need to parse in a few things. So first, we need to parse in the actual the query. So we pass that in. And then secondly, we then need to define the Lexer that we're using. So we're using the Postgres Lexer. And then finally, we then pass in the terminal formatter. So we're essentially just describing the fact that we're using the terminal. We want data in the terminal to be formatted, if you like. Again, there's loads of different parameters there that you can pass in. Good. I've just pressed up, and now we've completely ruined that. So we're going to need to type that in again. So luckily, I have it all copied and pasted ready. So there we go. So that's the kind of final output here. So let me just run this again. Apologies. So if I run that, we can now see the output. So we can see what's happening here. The SQL statement is being broken up with these keywords that are utilized in our SQL statement. It's in a kind of a top-down approach, which is going to make it a lot easier for us to view. Just to showcase what I was referring to earlier and what isn't very well detailed in the in documentation re-indent here. If I set this to the default false, let's just run this again. Now X already exists, so we just need to run this again and then run this command again. And you can see we have this kind of line format again, block format, if we use the re-indent set to false.